to Toastmaster Sulata.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sean. Good evening, Toastmasters. Through our next session, we will touch upon a very fundamental aspect of Toastmasters' experience, that is mentoring. Mentoring is a brain to pick, an ear to listen, and a push in the right direction. A good mentor helps the mentee with tips to prepare good speeches, role taking, and club responsibility. The mentor helps the mentee to view his own potential, grow, and achieve his educational goals. The pride that a mentor feels on witnessing the mentee develop and become a good speaker is worth experiencing. A good mentee, on his part, absorbs from the vast pool of the mentor's knowledge and experience, uses it to grow and achieve his targets. Over a period of time, with a constant interchange of ideas, a bond, a camaraderie develops between the mentor-mentee duo, and this is indeed worth watching. So here today, we have with us a dialogue session between the mentor, a few experienced mentor-mentee pairs from our very own home club, the MTM. So first, to begin with, I invite the gracious and dignified DTM, Mrs. Anita Cordero, who is mentor to none other than our energetic and vibrant Toastmaster, Seema Siquera. Over to you, Toastmaster Seema.
Thank you, Sulata. I, Toastmaster Marina Seema Siquera, am proud and elated to introduce to you all my mentor, guide, and a close friend who had inspired my hope to learn more, ignited my imagination to write more, and instilled in me love for Toastmasters from the day I joined Mangalore Toastmasters Club. An English teacher by profession, she is a distinguished Toastmaster who has climbed the ladder of success from being the president of the club to the area director, club assurance chair, and the division director. Being a member of MTM for the past 16 years, she has also joined Konkani Toastmasters Club and Let's Debate Toastmasters Club recently. If I have gained some leadership qualities to become a club coach and conduct youth leadership programs successfully, she is my inspiration and motivation. Here I present to you, dear Toastmasters, my mentor, DTM Anita Cordero. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Seema.
You are mentoring many Toastmasters for more than a decade. As your protege, when I have learned so much from you, I want to ask you today one simple question. Could you tell me what is the learning you had from your mentees?
Okay, thank you. Good evening, Toastmasters and Toastmaster President Sunita. Thank you for this opportunity to share with the club about my experience in mentoring. I think mentor-mentee relationship is a two-way track. It's not just the mentee who is experiencing some learning, but also the mentor who gives the learning. I think in the past few years that I have taken up mentoring, I have learned quite a bit about Toastmasters and other experiences from my mentees. But I would like to share just three things here. The most important thing that I have learned about mentoring and about from my mentees is that even every mentee that comes to you is quite different. It's a unique person altogether. So even if you have a tried and tested strategy with you, you cannot say that it is going to be successful with all the mentees that you have. Perhaps with one person, I may have had a very good strategy and it has worked very well, but I have seen it becoming a total flop with the second mentee. So what I've learned is that every mentee comes to you with their basic learning needs. They come to you from different backgrounds and they have different objectives for joining the club. So assessing these, their learning needs, their objectives for joining, and their background is very much important before we start the role of mentoring. The second thing that my mentees have taught me is that there is absolutely no limit to what you can achieve. I take the example of my own Seema over here, Divyashree is over here, and I'm so very proud of them because they have taught me whether it is creativity, whether it is leadership, or whether it is communication. You cannot put a limit to it. You can just expand and grow and grow. And while some of them have limited themselves to the club and the area, some of them have really stepped out of that bond and have showed that there are ample opportunities for growth even outside. So much so that I have sat back and have been amazed at what they have achieved. And I totally feel proud and happy that my mentees have been able to do so much. And the third important thing that I have learned from my mentees is that I have to give them the respect that they deserve. You know, very often as a mentor, I'm scared. I'm hesitant to push forward or to push my mentees because I feel that I am putting up my image or my version of it on them. And I don't want that to happen. So I have to withdraw and let them go because I know that when they are confident, they can go quite far and they can achieve a lot. So I have learned that because there have been mentees with me who the moment I tried pushing them, they would just restrain themselves. They wouldn't come forward. So, but when I step back, they will come forward and, ma'am, can I do this? Anita, can we do it? Can I do this like this? And that has been really a rewarding thing for me. So they deserve the respect in the sense, some of them want to go at a very fast pace, but some of them do not. So I have to respect their pace. I have to respect their method of going about, their own style of doing things. And I have to encourage them while correcting them or putting them on the right track. It is quite a challenge, but today when I see the mentees have turned my mentors, I take the example of Divya today. I learned so much from Divya, and every time I have a doubt, I go to her. I do not know when the roles have reversed, when she became my mentor and I became a mentee, but definitely the roles have reversed. And today I'm very happy and proud to sit back and say, my mentees are achieving a lot. It is a very proud moment, just like a mother feels proud of her children. Today, I feel very proud of my mentees who are here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. When you start speaking, pearls spill out from your mouth. So much to learn from you that now I, as a mentor, am following you, your path that you have shown to me. Thank you for that. Over to you, Toastmaster Sulata.
Thank you. We now have the cool and charismatic Toastmaster Kavita, mentor to the talented and smart Toastmaster Deepali. Over to you, Toastmaster Deepali.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sulata. A mentor is someone who allows you to see the hopes inside yourself. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters. It's an honor to be a part of this session because I get to introduce to you my mentor and my confidant, Toastmaster Kavita Kamat. Toastmaster Kavita Kamat has all the qualities of a fluent communicator, competent leader, and a reliable mentor. In my journey of Toastmaster, she has been an anchor influencing me to give speech, encouraging me to take up role and supporting me through it all. In the beginning, I thought that Toastmasters is mentoring was only about a person who mentors your speeches and encourages you to take up roles. But I was wrong. Little did I know that when you get a mentor, You get a mentor for life. Okay, Toastmaster Kavita has been the best mentor and a friend. From informing us mentees about the various roles in Toastmasters on our WhatsApp group to being a role model in Toastmasters. Taking in charge of YLP last year, she practices what she preaches. I am very proud to be your mentee, Toastmaster Kavita Kamath. I would like to ask you one question as a mentee. How does trust play a vital role in benefiting the mentees? Over to you, Toastmaster Kavita.
Thank you, Toastmaster Deepali, for those kind words. I don't know whether I really deserve that, but it was very much what you have explained about me. But I would first take the opportunity to thank Toastmaster President Sunita, who has given us this opportunity to share our views to Mangalore Toastmasters about mentorship. And it will always encourage other members who have finished level two to take up mentoring, because mentoring is a beautiful experience which builds up the word trust. And trust is very important for each individual, whether it's a mentor or a mentee. Trust is the substance of all the successful relationship. It is not only the mentor, but the mentee also needs to build the trust between themselves. When I started my journey as a mentor, this is 2 years down the line, I enjoyed this experience. But what I realized is to get connected to them easily, I started with a WhatsApp group so that I could easily connect with them and know their difficulties and help them during their needs. To build up a trust, there are three major things which are very important. That is availability. When the mentee needs you, you need to be available to them. And you should be a very good listener, as the mentees who have recently joined have got a lot of questions to ask us, because they don't know right from what is a DCP point to taking up roles in the club level. And we as mentors need to guide them to be better leaders and also to deliver their speeches well. So we need to train them as good leaders and good speakers as well. But with all this, they should be a good human being. And that is important only if that trust is getting connected between you and your mentee. In every relation, trust is very important. Trust between the mentor and mentee is said to be a cornerstone of effective mentorship relationship. So as I've already said, you should be a good active listener and you should be available to them and analyze them well. Each mentee, to build up a mentee-mentor relationship trust is different with each mentee. The comfort zone with the mentor-mentee relation is very, very important. And that you'll be at ease only if, as a mentor, you will be able to make them feel comfortable. And that is when you connect to them on weekly or monthly basis to let them know what are their needs and where they need to improve. Each of us learn pathways. Each of us learn to take up roles at club levels. But for that, we need to help them out. For that, a mentor should talk straight and clear, demonstrate respect, create transparency to the mentee, and keep giving them some or the other deadline so that they reach their goals well. So that trust factor, if you build, the mentee also will reach goals in a very smooth way. As Madam President has already informed us, to let our mentees know to complete at least one level, which will benefit not only the club, but the individual. As Divya currently mentioned about individual goals, we as mentors should build that trust up and see that our mentees reach that goal in a great way. So I truly believe that trust plays a vital role in Toastmasters and in our lives, wherein we can allow our mentees to grow and reach greater heights. And I always want my mentees to shine and step higher than what we are today, and we would look at them as those timing stars at MTM. Over to you, Deepali. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kavita. Over to Solata.
Thank you, Toastmaster Deepali. I now invite the dynamic and confident DTM Sukanya, who is mentor to the melodious and cheerful Toastmaster Chandru. Over to you, Toastmaster Chandru.
Thank you, Solata. Good evening to all. I feel proud to introduce a distinguished Toastmaster, Sukanya Rao, who is my mentor, a charter member of MTM and held all the club office bearers' role, including the president. Very active member of our club, and she is so fond of MTM that she rejoined after taking a break on personal commitment. Also served as a district officer as area director of Division F. Though she has secured a doctorate in personal finance from NITK, don't like to be called as Dr. Sukanya, but DTM Sukanya. As a financial consultant, she has helped many people in managing their finance and also ensured their peaceful retirement life. Is a soft-spoken, calm and composed nature and very helpful and resourceful person. On helping count, she has never say no attitude. Always willing to lend her helping hands to every member of the club. And for my growth in Toastmasters, in Toastmasters, her contribution is immense. She has not only pushed me to take up different roles, at the same time, she has helped me with the resources. Also, she has mentored me beyond Toastmasters as well. My MBA from IGNO would not have been possible without her help. And I owe a lot to DTM Sukanya. But my party to her still pending. She is a person of varied interest, a voracious reader, member of ham radio, interested in meditation, relaxation technique, and she is presently teaching the students of Sayadri Engineering College. Thank you, DTM Sukanya, for mentoring me for so many years. As a mentee, I have got only one question for you. You have been mentoring for the last many years, and I am sure all of your mentees got benefited because I am one of them. Please tell us how you plan your mentoring, and do you have a different strategy for each mentee? Over to Sukanya.
Thank you, Chandru, for that very lengthy introduction. To answer your question, how do I plan my mentoring? Like my previous speakers said, mentoring is a two-way street. Both have to be committed to the relationship of mentor and mentee, and also have to be very clear as to where they require the mentoring. The mentee has to be very clear. And like Anita mentioned, it's not only the mentee who learns from the mentor, although the mentor is a little more experienced and probably more knowledgeable, but it's also the mentor who learns a lot from the mentee. So how do I handle my mentor? I don't really have a very, a plan as such, but generally whenever a mentee comes to me, I look at how can I help this mentee. So I kind of ask questions as to what could be the strengths and weaknesses of this person. And on that basis, I start working on the mentee. The kind of mentees that I've had, each of them have had very different needs. So some of the mentees would have required help in the language. Some of them require help in generating ideas. And some of them, just need a boost in their confidence. So what I do is I look at the mentee and I think about how I can help this mentee and how I can encourage this person. What would work for this person? So these are the things that I really focus on. And accordingly, I work with the mentee. So it's not like, one plan which works for everyone. And just like how in my financial planning, one plan will not work for every client. It's very, very customized. So in the same way, For the mentee also, it's very, very customized. Each one, I look at their needs, and on that basis, I mentor them. So that is all I have to say. But what I have understood is that it's been an extremely enjoyable journey for me, mentoring the different mentees, because it's been such a great learning experience for me as well. So that's all. Thank you very much. Back to you, Sulata.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Sukanya, for sharing the insight. And this would definitely help the members who are going to take up the mentor role in future. Over to Sulata.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chandrasekhar. I will now invite the elegant and graceful DTM Toastmaster Gladys, who is mentor to the hardworking and committed Toastmaster Ranjini. Over to you, Toastmaster Ranjini.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sulata. Good evening, all. Toastmasters Gladys, you are a banker by profession, working in Karnataka Bank, Mangalore. Enjoys reading, watching movies, and painting. According to you, knowledge can be acquired by learning, but experience can be achieved only by doing. So age is just a number, and learning is a continuous process. You feel we can learn the best things from the worst time of our life if we keep our minds and hearts open to that situation and are willing to learn. Public speaking is your passion. I have heard your speeches in club meetings, and the one which is still in my memory, picture of Konkani speech in Kulshekar Church. An excellent humorous speech. Yes, I have noted that you have good voice modulation, and you express the thought and keep the audience engaged throughout the speech. Sumana Ghate introduced you to Toastmasters, and you are a long-standing active member of Mangalore Toastmasters Club. You always want to better yourself by trying new roles. In virtual meetings, you take up Zoom host, Google Form, sharing slide, and you want to learn more. The way you evaluate by giving valuable suggestions and tips, building confidence of the speaker. Toastmaster Gladys, you believe that there is no end to education. I have a question. I recently joined you as a mentee. How would you differentiate between a Toastmaster under the guidance of mentor and the one without a mentor?
Thank you, Ranjini, for your lengthy introduction of me. I don't know whether I'm really worthy of it. And Sulata, I'm not a DTM, by the way. I should have acquired that position long back, but somehow maybe by my laziness or what, I don't know. And I think I should take a cue from all the mentors, my previous mentors. Anyways, let me illustrate the answer to Ranjini's question by my own experience in life. When I learned a life-saving skill, that is swimming in the pool at St. Aloysius College, just to save a few thousands of rupees, I didn't take a coach. And so for a month, I was flailing my arms in the swimming pool. And even I displaced a large amount of water to every day. But I never learned swimming for a month. And I was just in the pool. But then I decided enough is enough. And I paid 1,000 rupees and I engaged a coach. And believe me, within a month, slow, a little by little, first I learned how to breathe and then I started to float. And by the end of 1 month, I was able to swim from, and a luscious pool, if you all have been there, it is a big pool. And I was able to swim from one end of the pool to the other. So in Toastmasters too, the mentor does a lot of handholding and guides you and makes things much more simpler for you. So always, a mentor is a good person to have for you. A mentor is a must, I feel. So a mentee should always reach out to a mentor. A manual, especially the projects which are there in Pathways, it is sometimes daunting, and many a times it is indecipherable too. So mentor could make things much more better for you, make things simpler, and the roles also, when you are in doubt, you can always reach out to the mentee, to the mentor, and they will make things much more easier for you. And the mentors always help you build your confidence, prod you and push you so that you are able to achieve your goals. And my own personal experience, Sukanya, who is my mentor even now, she made every speech of mine better. And regarding my humorous speeches, whenever I was not able to put in humor, the queen of humor, that is Janice, I went to her and she was able to help me with my humorous speeches. And many other times I would take help from Anita too. So always, a mentor always helps you to achieve better. So definitely, I would always lean back upon my mentors to do well in Toastmasters and achieve my goals. Over to you, Ranjini.
Thank you, Toastmaster Gladys. I really well said. It is all the words. Yata Raja, Tata Praja. Hope I'll follow you. Thank you. Over to Toastmaster Sulata.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ranjini. And Toastmaster Gladys, I'm sure today's session will inspire you to aim for the DTM title soon. And hopefully, yes, and hopefully with your talent and capabilities, you will gain it too. All the best to you, Toastmaster Gladys. And next, I would like to invite the multi-talented and enthusiastic DTM Divya, who is mentor to our charming Toastmaster Radha. Over to you, Toastmaster Radha.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sulata. A very good evening to everyone. I'm Radha Sharma from Mangalore Toastmasters Club. I joined the club a couple of years ago, and ever since it has been a learning process for me. When I joined the club, everything seemed a little confusing and I felt a little lost, which is very obvious because when you join a new entity, a club or any organization, you feel a little apprehensive about that place. New people, new members, new settings, and new rules and regulations about the club, which you're not aware of. And hence, at the back of your mind, you feel that if somebody was there to guide you and make you feel comfortable in that environment. So I'm lucky to have been assigned my mentor, Toastmaster Divya Shri Gati, a friend, philosopher, and guide, and a person who is very helpful and available whenever I needed her. Well, a personality who dons many hats. To recall some of her role takings and her achievements and her designations, she joined Toastmasters as a member in March 2014, joined MTM in March 2017. She was the VP of Inspirian Toastmasters in the year 2014-15. She has been the president of Inspirian Toastmasters in the year 2015-16. She was the program chair of Jamboree in 2015 semi-annual. She was the area director of F2 and D92 in 2017-18. LDP coordinator of Karnataka in 2018-19. She was a mentor chair of District 92 in 2019-20. And in 2021-22, assistant PQD for area F3. Well, there are a whole lot of designation that she has. So many feathers in her cap, I must say. Since today it's a mentor and a mentee meet, I would like to ask my mentor, Toastmaster Divya, as a mentor, how do you gauge that one unique quality or the strength of your mentee, and how do you try to help them accomplish their goals? Over to you, Divya.
Thank you, Radha. When she asked all my designations, that's when I realized that, okay, what have I actually done in Toastmasters? I think I've taken up opportunities in Toastmasters. And when an opportunity of a mentor came, to me, I was flabbergasted, because till then it was me taking care of me, and the focus point was always me. Right at this moment, there was somebody else whom I was responsible for. Now, what do I do? For every task you can do in life, there's a checklist. But for a mentor, there is no checklist. Whatever you can do, you do, and still, and yet, you can fail. So when it came to the point when I became a mentor, I did one little task which I do well. I talked. But I talked to my mentee that they talk more back to me. So the swimming pool was a perfect example that was running in my mind, which I had to give. And I do a little differently than Gladys does. I'm the one who will take them to that baby pool and tell them everything that's required till they complete their level one. I mentor their speeches. I listen to their speeches. I tell them every single rule. Whatever can fail, I tell them about it till they complete their level one. After that, I throw them to the 10-foot pool. Now you got to swim yourself. That's my strategy. Now you tell me when you need help. If you're going to ask for help, I'm there. If you're going to drown, I'll pick you up. But I'm not going to push you henceforward, because you know how it works. By now, I would have told them enough about Toastmasters to see where they can benefit and how they can benefit. And that's been my simple mantra. I believe that they cannot be my replicas. I believe that I cannot be the same way that I would treat myself, my growth. Firstly, I understand is why you are here and what do you want out of it. Each mentee of mine is unique. They're not only in my club, they're in different clubs. So I asked them, why are you here? So Radha was very clear what she was here for. Oliver is very clear what he was there for. In the next 1 year, if I don't see the goal that they've achieved in that year, that's when I change my strategies. Now, every strength is not told. Some are identified by the way they talk to you, by the way they change or evolve. And that only happens because of observations and interactions. The only thing you can do well as a mentor is observe, ask, and third, see the effectiveness of whatever you have done. If it fails, you will have to change your ways. If it doesn't, please let it go the way it is. So for me, it's about helping them at the beginning and then letting loose and say, now start flying, now start spreading your wings. Whenever you need, I'm there for you. And I'll keep that short and simple that way. Over to you, Samal. Sulata.
Thank you, Divya.
Thank you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Radha. Thank you.
And thank you, DTM Divya, as well. So thank you all for this wonderful and lively session. And as I said earlier, the rapport which I mentioned was clearly evident in this session. Being a mentee myself, I wish to compliment all the mentors here with this beautiful saying. A truly amazing mentor is hard to find, difficult to part with, and impossible to forget. So thank you all.